initiate mission. Start life-saving operations immediately on arrival, followed by securing and managing the scene, without waiting for radiation monitoring to begin. This mission consists of tactics numbered 6 and 7, and is conducted concurrently with the previous tactics and missions. Tactic 6, initiate life-saving rescue operations. First responders immediately begin life-saving rescue operations including search and rescue, fire suppression, and medical triage and treatment. These operations are not delayed because of the presence of radiation. Life-saving rescue operations must take priority over conducting radiological measurements or decontamination. Time working in the hot zone should be minimized and managed by supervisors to ensure responder safety by keeping potential radiological exposure as low as reasonably achievable. This is known as the ALARA principle. First responders should wear appropriate personal protective equipment to reduce the intake of airborne radioactivity and help mitigate contamination while performing life-saving rescue operations. Although desirable, radiological monitoring equipment is not required for rescue operations. The existence of a significant dangerous radiation zone greater than 10 arc per hour is unlikely, but possible. Even in an extreme case, with a very large radioactive source, causing an extended area of dangerous radiation fields at the incident site, it would be unlikely that responders would receive a dose higher than the 25 rem guideline for life-saving operations. Rapid rescue of casualties and minimizing time spent at the scene of an RDD is the best method for keeping radiation exposures ALARA. By 15 minutes after the initial detonation, the concentrations of airborne radioactivity will have substantially decreased, and the primary inhalation hazard will be from the resuspension of contamination on the ground. First responders should be alert for any possible localized high radiation levels due to partially or non-dispersed radioactive sources. Responders should also be alert for the possibility of a radioactive fragment that may have been embedded in a person. If not identified during triage, this type of wound could be a source of prolonged exposure to the patient and the responders who are treating the injured person. During Tactic 6, emergency management should consider issuing a second public message that includes information about the radiological hazard and reiterates the shelter-in-place message. Message templates can be found in Annex 2 of the document. For more information, turn to page 18 of the RDD Response Guidance.